the deputy leader distancing himself from the Queensland Premier after she declared every child under 12 is vulnerable to the virus if the state reopens. This was Richard Marles on the program earlier.
I would be distancing myself from the comments of Anastasia is the honest answer to that question. We need to be following the health advice. Not abandoning Anastasia. I think you can understand state premiers standing up for their states. That's what they're elected to do. But at the end of the day, we need a national interest here.
Well, let's bring in today Queensland reporter Jessica Millwood, who joins us from Logan. Jess, this all comes as Queensland faces a new COVID threat.
That's right, Ali. Our Premier under pressure in more ways than one this morning. Now her allies are abandoning her comments and COVID is on our doorstep. A COVID positive truckie was infectious in the community for 5 days here in Queensland. They are now back in New South Wales, but there are a number of exposure sites around this Beenleigh area. They include Total Tools, the Marketplace Shopping Centre behind me and Stylish Nails inside. Anyone who has been to these places is being asked to go and get tested. We are expecting more exposure sites to be revealed later today. Meanwhile, we've avoided a lockdown on the Gold Coast. Students were overheard at the Islamic College down there bragging that they'd been interstate to Victoria. Police are now investigating. It appears that they have breached a border barricade at an inland route. Initially, they weren't cooperating with authorities, but thankfully, the family now are. They are in hotel quarantine and overnight tested negative. And I have another update on Little Memphis, the little boy who has been stranded in regional New South Wales with his grandparents since July when the borders slammed shut. I've just been speaking with his mum, Dominique. That exemption was granted late last night and he is coming home and he's coming home today. Dominique is getting ready to chat to us on the Today Show and then she is being picked up by Angel Flight to go be reunited with her boy in Brisbane this afternoon.
Yeah, that chat coming up in the next 10 minutes.
In these unsettling times, it's good to know when times get tough, when our collective backs are against the wall, when there's no light in the dark tunnel. Our elected officials, the people we pay to sort things out, are working tirelessly to, well, sort things out.
You open up this state and you let the virus in here and every child under 12 is vulnerable.
The claim that children were not considered was false, wrong and inaccurate.
There has never been a more incompetent government than the New South Wales government.
It's on like Donkey Kong. Finance Minister Simon Birmingham is in Adelaide and Deputy Opposition Leader Richard Marles in Geelong. Morning, guys. Nice to see you this morning. To you, first of all, Simon, Josh Frydenberg said yesterday it's a, quote, desperate denial of reality and is not based on medical advice. Are you going to pull Queensland and WA into line as well?
Carl, look, what I'd urge every leader to do is to focus on facts, not fear, to accept some of the realities that we all have to acknowledge as well. COVID-19 is endemic across the world. The Delta variant is endemic across the world. We can see just how transmissible it is. We've got to just work with all of those facts. And those facts include the facts that vaccination is a pathway for us. As we hit those 70 and 80% markers, we can see through the data and the modelling that with some appropriate safeguards, we are able to keep our population safe, to resume some of the more greater normalities of life in places like New South Wales and Victoria. And we're hitting those vaccination targets at a great rate now. It took us 3 days to get from 19 million doses being administered across the country to 20 million doses being administered. Another 500,000 landed from Singapore overnight. Yeah. And we've just got to keep that going. And every state leader should focus on that as their number one priority.
So you're saying open up at 70% effectively. Do you know more than the AMA? Because they say if you open up, system will crash.
Carl, let's be clear. That is not what the plan says. It doesn't say open up at 70% and nothing happens from there. It says you take a very cautious, careful, staged approach. And so we don't want to encourage states to do things that are reckless at the 70% mark. We want to make sure everyone takes the careful approach. That's why there are 70% and 80% thresholds in place. That's why we're also opening up to kids from 12 to 15 and to be able to get them vaccinated in addition to those targets, which we'll see an even greater proportion of Australians with that protection. And it's through older siblings, parents, teachers, grandparents all being vaccinated that we're then able to protect those who are under 12, because right now nowhere in the world has approved vaccines for those under 12.
So is Anastasia Palaszczuk wrong?
Look, she is, I think, focusing on the fear side rather than on the factual, calm analysis that needs to be undertaken, on educating the population, and as I say, first and foremost, on encouraging that vaccine take-up to continue and to reach into every pocket of the community. That's the way a responsible leader should behave.
Richard, Anastasia Palaszczuk is copying it from all sides right now, even though health officials say she's probably right to keep it out as long as possible. You wouldn't leave her out to dry, would you?
Well, I think there are differing experiences being had across the country, and you can expect premiers are going to speak for their own experience and their own state. I don't want to see Australia in one extra day of lockdown than it needs to be. It's why we do support, Federal Labor supports the plan in the with the Doherty modelling. What's really important now is that the Prime Minister actually uses National Cabinet today to get everyone on the same page.
But you're not even on the same page. Are you on the same page as Anastasia Palaszczuk or not?
I would be distancing myself from the comments of Anastasia is the honest answer to that question. I mean, we need to be following the health advice when it comes to the impact and who we should be vaccinating when. We don't want to be spending an extra day in lockdown. But at the end of the day, you know, you can understand why states that don't have COVID want to stay in that situation. And we need to see the Prime Minister actually getting the country on a plan, on the same page, so that we get to the other side of this. But can I say, Carl, at the end of the day, the most critical thing here is getting the country vaccinated. And sure, we've seen a lot of people getting vaccinated in recent days, but we're still at a point where less than 30% of the entire population are vaccinated. We are playing catch-up footy, and that's fundamentally because Scott Morrison said this wasn't a race.
I can't believe I'm hearing this morning, that Federal Labor is abandoning Anastasia Palaszczuk, who's just trying to keep COVID out of her state.
It's not abandoning Anastasia. I think you can understand state premiers standing up for their states. That's what they're elected to do. But at the end of the day, we need a national interest here. There's one person who's been elected to provide that for the country. It's Scott Morrison. And from day one, he has patently failed to lead this country and to get the country on the same page.
At least, I mean, I'm not sure exactly what you're saying here, but I think before you said Anastasia was wrong, that's a conflict. Simon, I'm going to go back to you. The PM has been completely stuffed on Anastasia Palaszczuk. Is he worried about losing Queensland at the next election?
No, Carl. What we want to do is make sure everybody is focused, as we are, on delivery of the plan, and the plan about getting Australians vaccinated. Every state who doesn't have COVID spreading across their community at present should want to keep it suppressed for as long as possible while they drive their vaccine rates up to those 70 and 80% targets. There's nothing wrong with that. But what they shouldn't be doing as state leaders is whipping out fear, suggesting that even at those points of the plan, it still won't work.
So you're saying that's what she's doing?
Because we've built a plan based on scientific modelling. Well, that sounds exactly like what she was doing in those comments yesterday, and that's just not helpful. You know, as a leader, she needs to lead too, and her leadership should be about ensuring she is encouraging her state to hit those vaccination targets, to explain what the plan for the future means in terms of how we manage as a country and as each state, and to live with the realities of COVID, not just to whip up fear and scaremongering in ways that, frankly, are not constructive.
Well, at least you're both in this together, and it leaves Anastasia Palaszczuk on her own there in Queensland. And you know what happens in Queensland? She'll just get more popular. Thanks for your time today, boys. Really appreciate it. And have a great weekend. And good luck with that weather down there, Richard. It looks like a tempest. It's like National Cabinet this morning.
Oh, DJ to the rescue. Tone.
Everyone needs an umbrella holder.
It's because TJ came here.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. See you soon, TJ.